It happens all the time. People tell me I look like the lead singer of The Strokes, Julian Casablancas. Today, we're finally going to exploit this.
That's right, Mullen Music Express has contacted dozens of Strokes fans and music journalists, offering them an exclusive interview with rock star Julian Casablancas. For authenticity's sake, Danny will be hosting his guests in a luxurious hotel suite, and he will be carefully imitating Julian's look from a recent show. This means thrift shops, replica tattoos, and a mullet sculpted with love by an elite Beverly Hills stylist.
Why are we doing this? To convince these interviewers and fans that one of the most beloved musicians of the modern era is a fucking dickhead.
The Jews are cheap, and I don't like women or minorities. I voted.
Guys, this is in all seriousness my favorite stunt we've ever pulled. Please click the like button before we even get started. Help us fight the YouTube algorithmic bullshit and defeat these garbage channels. Also, subscribe, please. We need more recruits to the army.
I grew up on The Strokes. I would constantly blast through like all five of their albums that were out at the time in high school. Heavy influence for me personally.
When I got into Room on Fire, I mean, it really just set me on a tirade. And I can remember many days just going through high school, really just diving deeper and deeper into the discog and things like The New Abnormal coming out and just being like, wow, they're still kicking around and getting more creative.
How long have you been a journalist for?
I went back to school for it a couple years ago, and I've been doing the music writing thing for about 2-3 years now.
Nice.
Yeah.
Have you interviewed any other artists like Julian before?
No, definitely not.
So this is your first time?
Yeah.
Hello.
Hi.
How are you?
Hey.
Hello.
Yeah,
Katie, welcome to our humble abode.
Thank you.
What's up?
How's it going?
Good, how you doing?
Ooh, overwhelming. Gentlemen, lady.
So is this like new music that you're working on, or how is this like new project working out?
I guess with the new project coming out with The Strokes and wanting to take a little bit of a break from all that.
I had a mix of songs that I thought sounded like that kind of represented, the height of recording for me.
So this is kind of Phrases for the Young part two, I guess.
That's cool.
Katie, what bands do you like?
God, I like everything. Honestly, I like listen to a lot of pop, a lot of indie. I listen to a lot of old music. I am like actually really digging World War I music recently. It's very like sardonic and just like has this weird twisted sense of humor that I really like about it.
Damn. Was World War I when we were in Korea?
No, that was 1914 through 1918, so that was on the Western Front in France.
Which is the one where we were in the jungle and there was the president who was like...
World War II. That was Vietnam. I'm also fascinated by Vietnam.
Which track do you guys like off Phrases?
Is that the newest Voids thing, or I'm sorry?
That would be Virtue.
Virtue, sorry.
Who picked these fans and...
Oh no.
I'm gonna treat you both like Keith Moon would have treated a television. Going sailing.
So, talk about what are we here for today? You've got some music coming out. Talk about that a little bit.
Yeah. So, it's not a Strokes record. It's not a Voids record. It's just a Julian record. I feel like a sensitive subject with musicians is always their relationship to their label. Peter Edge was a guy who basically he shut down a lot of things that not only I wanted to do musically, but stuff I wanted to do personally too. It was known in like 2001, 2002 that we were one of those like really liberal bands whose, I guess, sexuality both in image and in choice of partner was sort of fluid before that was like even okay or whatever. And Peter Edge was the guy who basically crushed that dream with his Jack Boots too.
Do you feel like you're able to kind of put more of yourself into this?
Your name's AJ, right?
Yeah.
AJ, I feel so free now. We're promoting the new solo record, just buying it.
You even have official merch on how much you hate this guy.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he's a piece of shit. I'll put it on the record.
He's a piece of shit. On the record for me, I think he's kind of hot.
I think you're kind of hot. How's that sound?
Dude,
I mean, is the...
No, that's not, I don't think we should.
Is the cat out of the hat?
This is the interviewer, but we're maybe like one of the fans or something. We let Balthazar.
Balthazar.
Oh my God.
Balthazar.
So getting canceled, Julian.
Yo, what's up?
Hi, I like your tail.
That's good.
I'm Katie, nice to meet you.
Balthazar,
nice to meet you.
He is 18.
We checked his ID.
Excellent, good work.
I feel like, I guess, a broken record right now because we keep talking about RCA, but... you recognize this, right?
Every record store I can remember being in since I started collecting, yeah.
Contractually, we had to put one more record out with RCA, and we didn't want to. We didn't have the songs. We didn't have material to put out, so we basically just had to pump out, I'll say it, basically some garbage. Like that song, Welcome to Japan. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do, kill me now. Somebody take off one of your guitar strings and feed it into my eyeball until I bleed to death. This was kind of a fuck you to RCA. We just slapped the label right across the top of the album. So I want to show you what we've come up with right now. That's going to be my new album, tentatively scheduled to drop in early 2022. And I just want to know if you guys are offended by it or if you think it's cool. We're going to be calling the new one RC Gay. Just
yes.
Say it. And you can see it's me. I'm giving the middle finger to the... to hopefully Peter Edge, hopefully he picks up a copy. Is that fucking punk rock or what?
You know, I mean, it feels right. It just does, I don't know.
Do you know the song New York City Cops?
Mm-mm.
Oh, really?
No, I'm not familiar.
You would think,
I mean, I'm sure I've heard it, but I can't recall it off the top of my head.
You would think the journalist would know one of our most famous songs.
I'm sure I know it, but...
Don't be mean to her, Jules. Don't take offense to this. He's joking.
I'm not mad at her. That song originally was actually... It got pulled from the record pre-9/11 because people thought it was disrespectful to police and the firemen. Because like, the lyric is, New York City cops, they ain't too smart. The original lyric was...
New York City cops, taste somewhat dark.
Because like they say that like the bagels in New York City taste whatever better because of the water. I think the shower water in New York City showers makes penises like taste a little sour. I don't mean to get political, but did you guys vote in that 2016 election?
I was a minor, so no. Yeah.
Four letters for you guys. T-R-U-M-P. It's five letters, but I don't give a shit. Yeah.
You were there. You stormed.
Yeah. Like, you guys, does the date January 6th ring a bell to you guys?
Yeah.
People don't know he was there. Otherwise, you know, I'd be...
Wait, you were there?
Yeah, I was wearing a fisherman's parka and rain boots because I just wanted to keep a low profile.
Why did you out Ariel like that?
What?
Ariel.
Yeah, do you guys know Ariel Pink?
Ariel Pink is a musician from Los Angeles and a Trump voter. On January 6th, he attended the president's speech in Washington.
I've heard the name, yeah.
Yeah, he's one of my favorite musicians and a good friend. And him and I were there and we were just like, rah, rah.
Yeah.
And we followed in the first phalanx with the guy with like the horns and the fur. And we were gonna be in right behind him, but I guess this journalist from Pitchfork had a like a part-time gig for CNN, and she picked out Ariel, and I guess she'd reviewed his record Pom Pom, so she just, she wasn't gonna like mistake him. And then I told him, I was like, hey bro, I can't be seen here. Like, I mean, I want to go in there, and I want to literally force feed AOC a handful of my own feces, but my career, I'm not ready to, I guess, like commit career suicide yet.
Yeah.
And so I just wanted to wait a little bit. Do you guys know the song You Only Live Once by The Strokes? The first track off, which one is it? First Impressions?
Yeah.
You know that track? You know the demo version of it?
Yeah, actually I do.
Do you know what that demo was called?
It was a play on that title, right? I forget what it was.
I'll Try Anything Once.
Right.
Sit me down. Shut me up. I'll calm down.
What people don't know is that there was a demo, and it was the best lyrics that I ever wrote by far. It was going to come out untouched in that form, but Peter Edge, the Incubus, made me rewrite it with some sappy, nostalgic garble, and then he made me make it into this rock anthem that it was never supposed to be. The lyrics on their own, it was my War and Peace, you know? And we're gonna play it. Let's see. All right, ready to go? Black guys' penises are big. The Irish are drunk and there's no doubt. Mexicans aren't real good in school. They smoke too much weed and mess about. They get pregnant by sophomore year. By junior year they all drop out. And I say, Chinese girls have narrow eyes. You say, but they're quick to get in bed. Japanese make sushi and good cars too. Indian food smells like poo-poo. German men play with shit. The Polish are dumb and avoid business with Jews. Black women are all scared of ghosts. Gypsies steal and can cast spells. Women in general shouldn't drive. Eskimos all have pet whales. Dominicans in baseball games are so damn good that it's insane. Don't ever help the poor. Them reproducing is bad for our world. Black guys star in porn and Chinese girls are whores. German men play with shit. The Polish are dumb. And up, wait, I'm gonna let the fan get the honorary last line, and then you say, avoid business with Jews.
Avoid business with Jews.
I'm Jewish and gay.
And say, Trump 2024.
Trump 2024.
Trump 2024.
You say, this guy's on heroin.
This guy's on heroin.
Yeah, my dude's on heroin.
Say, this girl's got a nice set of titties.
Hell yeah, Julian.
excited to.
Thanks, Jake.
I don't even care about that.
Okay. Say it. Just go for it.
I mean, they are nice.
Nice set of titties. Say that me, Jake, maybe the camera guy if he plays his cards right, and yeah, that's it. Say me, Jake, and the camera guy are gonna triple team this girl's titties tonight.
Hell yeah, Julian.
Triple teaming.
Thanks, Jake.
And Jules, I'll be in the bathroom.
Say we're gonna have our keyboardist play us something nice and soothing in E major while we ram, or at least attempt to ram, the headstocks of our guitars up her pussy.
Hell yeah, Julian, that's fine.
Thanks,
you're
Jake.
On one today.
I'm feeling crazy. That was too far. That was a little too far.
I like that shit.
So how do you see this new album as a progression for your songwriting?
I used to really lean heavily into music theory. Like, whether it was a diminished, pentatonic minor, or whether I was jamming in a blues scale or a Dorian.
You were in Melodoxian more than anything, be real.
Yeah, like, you mentioned my first solo album, that song River of Brake Lights, that song's like Melodoxian all day. Was it getting the hang of it, getting... So, I just, for this one, I really wanted to take music theory. I wanted to wad it up like a used baby diaper and just throw it in a wastebasket. I really just wanted to pay no attention to Eastern, Western, any kind of musical theory at all, and just let myself be a child again on the instrument. It's called Race Cars.
Oh.
Racing cars, drinking in bars, every summer, every fall.
Yeah.
You ready for the dinosaur song?
T-Rex in the woods. He wants to eat food. Food for him is another dinosaur.
I rode my trolley into the city the other day. Peter Edge made me get married when I was gay. The trolley is the only place I feel happy.
I
can almost sense that motherfucker Jake about to come.
This is good,
man. Fucking Jake. A baby in the moonlight. If another guy comes near you, I will fight. I will fight. A baby in the moonlight.
This is the punk duration of it.
Right? What are you gonna say?
I mean, I'm trying to formulate. I can't even.
You're such a cocksucker.
No, I'm serious. It's just fucking. I'm serious. It made me think of my dad and shit, man.
Baby in the moonlight.
Well, could we get a picture together? Would that
absolutely
be okay?
Yeah, absolutely.
Cool.
Yeah, right.
This feels like fucking like the.
Do you party?
No, I don't.
You don't,
No, I don't.
Okay.
I don't. But I appreciate the offer so much.
If one were to, I
like cocaine, but
yeah,
I don't like heroin.
Well, we all do. I mean, that's...
I used to have a little bit of an issue with painkillers, mm-hmm. so mm-hmm. I'm 4 years clean from that.
Oh, okay.
So, yeah.
Do you still do coke, though?
I still do coke, yeah.
Well, you're taking your sobriety seriously, then.
Yeah, exactly. Mm-hmm.
I mean, I tell people all the time, like... A lot of my best songs were in heroin babies.
Yeah.
11th Dimension, a song you like. You think I could write that fucking key riff if I wasn't browned out of my skull?
Yeah.
I don't think so.
Whatever gets you, baby.
So good, Julian.
That wasn't even in key. Now I know you're bullshit.
No, the riff on that song just fucking blew me away the first time.
I can't take this yet.
yeah.
I never was so good at shaking hands.
I can't handle it.
Blowing his mind right now.
The frozen surface of a fireball.
You know what you're doing to me, man.
Where cities come together.
The heroin is gone.
To hate each other in the name of sport.
Come on, man.
Oh my God.
America.
I'm busting. Oh, don't do it, bro. It's too good. It's too good.
He's completely straight.
Don't be sad.
You're blowing me away, bro.
It's definitely like a childhood dream to be meeting him. So like,
to be that close, I was like, what? What's going on right now, you know? It's surreal.
Do you think you were being completely honest when he was showing you his new stuff?
Were
you nervous to express your own?
I mean, like, obviously how everyone will react will be the same is a good question. But like, what did I think of like his art? I thought it was like refreshing to see him at least be like,
refreshing.
You know, yeah, mm-hmm. Refreshing is the term I would say.
Right.
Yeah.
He's a little abrasive at times.
Can you just say that he was nice to the camera? I don't think he would appreciate you.
I'm sorry,
like that.
But yeah, no, he was really nice and he was super sweet.
Yeah.
So I really enjoyed meeting him.
I'm so glad you got this experience.
Yeah.
It's awesome.
No, it was a great experience. And I mean, I didn't mean to say anything.
Oh, no, you're totally fine. You didn't say anything.
So. Yeah.
Yeah, we'll scratch that from the camera, right?
Okay, I'm sorry.
No, you're totally fine.
Yeah.
Totally good. Well, I think that's all we have for you.
Did I say something bad?
No, you're totally fine.
Okay.
Yeah. He doesn't like when people are too critical of him. So that's why, you know, Jake is in the mix.
Yeah.
Obviously. But, you know.
Yeah. No, I did really enjoy.
Job.
I did really enjoy meeting him, and he was very sweet at the end. And
awesome.
So,
not in the
yeah.
Commentaries, live streams, vlogs with my girlfriend from UCLA, extra content, 40 minutes, 30 minutes, an hour of extra content every single week to accompany every video. Guys, these are just some of the benefits available on my Patreon, link down in the description. I don't know what to say. We don't get ad revenue from my channel, hardly ever, either from copyright issues with using songs, like clearly this video did, or just from outright demonetization because shit's inappropriate. So if you guys like what we're doing, you like these high budget stunts, please, please support us. And at $5 to join the Patreon, it's never been a better bargain. There's so much goddamn content on there. So thank you guys, and let's get back to the video. 20 years ago, the great Is This It by The Strokes was released. This is the record that brought back rock.
Yeah!
Julian Casablancas said about the record Is This It that he wanted it to feel like a band from the past making a record in the future. And you can hear it with the fuzzy guitar riffs, the 60s throwback playing. Today, we're gonna be the Danny Mullen crew of 2018, making a video in the now!
Yeah!
Back when Inland Iggy was getting whipped against that door.
Good!
Back when Leo, we didn't know the extent of his sex addiction.
2018,
that's when you could walk into your doctor's office and not get a disappointed look.
Yeah, 2018, I was still learning the ways of the fat, you know? I was still getting in tune with the fat.
Well, you could say you're a black belt now, couldn't you?
Twofold. Two stripes.
2018, where we kept it simple and just had ourselves a good time.
Someday, yet hurts to say.
I got some bad news, gentlemen. Andy Dick, he didn't think my little B. Julian Casablancas overdose in the shower FaceTime Andy Dick joke was funny last night. He thought I was really overdosing and I was really Julian.
Where are you guys from?
LA.
Oh,
no. I go see if he's chilling. Yo. Oh my god, dude. Yo.
Wait, what?
Yo, Austin.
Yeah.
Get the fuck out of here.
Shh. Yo, get the fuck out of here with the camera, dude. Yo. Get the.
No, it's fine. Don't, because then it's gonna be a whole thing.
Just
calm down.
Are you gonna
calm
call
down.
An ambulance?
No, because he's sober.
He wants to talk to Andy. Yeah. He wants to talk to Andy.
Andy's here. We don't have it.
What about like a little bit of like what about a little like crystal? You think a little bit of crystal meth would like help out a little bit?
Turn the camera off.
How about this? I took a picture of three of these guys. Mudflap, I'm sorry. We're hoping. This might turn into Patreon content, but we're really hoping he has a change of heart. Maybe he comes out of his depressed mood. Maybe he does a few lines to get him out of that depressed mood.
Hopefully there's some time between then and now.
And we can get a makeout with Andy Dick tonight. That's what we're looking for. I'm sending him a picture of Iggy, and then I'm sending him a picture of Austin, and then I'm sending him a picture of Leo. That's just my guess as to what his type is. And then let me get a picture of you, Mudflap. There we go. If you want to tit fuck this land walrus, be our guest.
Let's go, Andy.
That's funny.
Guys, since this is a 2018 throwback video, I thought we'd bring back something from UCLA in 2018. Austin, I believe this is one of your favorite videos.
It's my favorite.
Cigarettes outside.
Okay. In the weight room, though? Here's the deal, guys. We gotta smoke an entire pack of cigarettes in a building before we get kicked out.
Yes! That's a great one.
Unopened pack of Marlboro Reds. Mr. Fake Country, of course, is very against the mask laws, but sometimes that doesn't pay off. He's gonna have to pick up whatever this mask is.
I'm not gonna bring it. I'm gonna wear a mask now?
Yeah.
It's the sneak in.
Get that mask. Let's check it. Let's get in close on it. Show it to the camera.
Yeah, disinfect it? Yeah.
Oh my god, you're an animal, dude.
Wait, this should be good if my calculations are correct. All right, safety first, kids.
Oh my god.
All right,
god.
Let's go.
Put it back on. That's your responsibility. It's like, think of yourself as a Navy SEAL. You cannot leave any man behind. Nothing like coming back to my alma mater. Leo, what do you have to tell us? Why have you called this town hall meeting?
I've called this town hall meeting to let everybody know that
you're about to call Mudflap fat, weren't you?
Oh, absolutely.
I can absolutely see that's
you
what you were
knew
doing.
It.
Yep, that was.
There's a ladder to the projector room.
What will you be screening today, Brother Ignatius? Citizen Kane? Bridge over the River Kwai?
All hail the penis!
Oh.
Ignatius, lay down your car.
Yeah, we don't allow smoking on campus. Yeah, like not even outside.
What? I've been drinking all day and I gotta smoke when I drink. Like, I'm fucked up.
He's a mudflap.
He's a mudflap.
I'm gonna offer you right now a Trust Dam vanilla flavored dental dam. No way. No way they're selling a dental dam. You know what analingus is?
I think I heard it, but I'm not sure what it is.
Show him how to use it.
Wow, he's good. He's good. Whoa. Yeah,
it's even vanilla flavored. Taste it.
They're gonna be right underneath your own keyboard. Anyway.
All right, thank you, man. Have a good one.
It's not going backwards.
Bullshit!
Is it on right now or you just won't carry it?
It is on, it just won't go.
It won't go with just me?
A bird won't do it. It's gonna take a California condor to move your ass.
That's funny.
Later, man. So listen, there's an easy approach to content creation, and then there's a dangerous, almost certainly illegal approach. Originally, somebody else, one of the underlings, was gonna hop this fence, get up on the platform and jump it. I decided that somebody's gonna do this, it's gonna be me. Say if one of you guys jumps, belly flops, gets yourself knocked out, drowns. I mean, I would lose upwards of 45 minutes of sleep tonight. All right, well, Julian Casablancas is an aspiring diver now.
Oh, yeah.
The fucking jump is not my primary concern. The primary concern is that UC police are a crack force, and I don't think they want me in there right now. Andy.
Hold on, man. Really? That's
so, can you tell him to turn the light down?
You're gonna get this the whole time.
Andy, I gave him direct orders to disobey you. How else can we film at nighttime? I recently read a gossip book called Meet Me in the Bathroom about the New York City rock and roll scene circa 2001 to 2012. And page 241, Albert Hammond Jr. alleges, and Albert Hammond Jr. is the guitarist of the Strokes, that you and him made out in a bar on the Lower East Side of Manhattan after a show.
Probably true.
20 years later, sitting around this table, a member of my fake Stroke band can make out with you tonight.
Oh, okay.
And this is our replica Albert Hammond Jr.
And he's the lead singer?
Guitar player. You did well for yourself, Andy, but not that well.
No, I don't know them.
I can't sing, but I was blessed to play the guitar. I have magic fingers.
He's blessed below the belt, too, Andy.
Why do you keep thinking?
No, I don't know.
My mouth or where?
I don't know.
Sorry.
Would you like to see it just as a...
Take a look at it.
Sure.
Sounds like you guys. Show Andy Dick your cock.
You talk to everybody. Everybody loves seeing you, Scott.
No, I don't need to see a picture. You're right here.
Yeah.
Walk his
face.
Yeah, okay. I'm afraid of it. It's like an anaconda. Do you have any liquor?
I need you. When Andy Dick comes back out.
Time out.
Mm-hmm.
Has my part on the channel ever been questioned?
No. Well, no. Except for he didn't carry the cross up the hill,
okay,
though.
So there's that one time. You know how we always make... I promise you now, it's not in question.
Yeah.
We want you to use a specific word. I think he should sort
of
call him
Leo, I don't need
daddy
your advice. It's like a fat chick telling her skinny friend how to get girls. It just doesn't help
you
me.
You start calling him daddy out of nowhere. Okay, that's what I want you to do.
Yeah, they were dying, like, first batch.
The old gypsies, huh?
That's what Lucas had.
Yo.
Lucas walked right... Am I allowed to say black friend?
He sat on it.
Do you mind? Daddy, that was my lighter, not his.
No, I'm talking about the cigarette.
Just call him daddy?
Yeah.
Are you calling him daddy?
Andy, everything is about consent. That's your rule, right?
No, it's called the law.
the roast of Pamela Anderson.
Can you tell us about your experience?
Now, that was all, honestly, the roast of Pamela. I'm friends with her. Mm. I said, look, I have an idea where I grab your titties and go, pew, pew, pew.
though.
Yeah, it's a tit rocking.
Right? As long as they got assault.
As long as they got assault.
Consensual.
damn, Andy.
You think?
So I was on Kimmel first, and then she came on, and he said, just stay. Just move over. So I moved over, she came out, and she had...
she had her legs, I don't know why they're showing, she must have had a skirt on or something.
Kid, come on, take it easy, you fucking velveteen bitch ass.
Whoa, you're gonna be calling me daddy later on. Let's get this straight, Andrew.
Come on.
Andrew.
So anyways, do you want to hear the story?
I'm listening, Ivanka? I'm all ears.
Ow, you're hurting my knee.
Oh. I'll hurt something else later.
No, she was on this side though.
Mm-hmm.
Kimmel. And her legs, and I was drunk. What can I do with you?
I'll be Pam.
Yeah. No. Ivanka.
Oh, wow.
Her legs had this weird makeup on that was glittering. And I just went like this. That's it.
What was going on with him?
Glitter. That's sexual misconduct.
What I'm hearing is if I did something like...
Oh.
Well, there we go. It's proven. I can do what I want with Andy Dick.
I just want to say Andy Dick on Cameo. Hey,
he's great on Cameo.
When I said that you could tit fuck this land walrus, did that offer entice you?
Wait, you weren't enticed.
The only picture I like that you sent is this guy.
That's the only one you like?
My neck is actually quite sore. So.
Austin, you remember the game 7 Minutes in Heaven?
I'm not playing 7 Minutes.
We're not enemies, we just disagree. If I was like him, all pissed in this bar, he changes his mind, says I went too far. We all disagree, I think we should disagree. Yeah.